I'm going to my concerns are as follows. The lady has not adhered to his employment contract. On page seven, section 11of his employment contract states, the county shall pay the employee $4,000 for the relocation of himself and family to Taylor County, Florida. He took the $4,000 relocation money within 5 months to relocate himself and family to Taylor County. We are almost 22 months into the contract, and Mr. Lakey has still not relocated his family to Taylor County that I know of. Second, employees, no matter what position they hold, are supposed to come to work and fulfill their duties. He is also absent. Uses comp time after attending evening meetings. Recently, attempted to use comp time for 6 days off. It is my understanding in the past he has used comp time liberally for days off. I'm told when he's in town, he regularly leaves throughout the day, sometimes without telling anyone his whereabouts, and at other times, he is going to his house to see about repairs. He has a history of leaving work early. I've even been told an employee he was leaving the office door open and then lock on in case someone came by, and he didn't come back to turn the light off and lock the door. He did not return. I'm not sure he's supposed to pull 40-hour weeks since he's been here. I'm not sure of that. He has not always given notice to the board when he was going to be absent until I spoke with him about it. Still, most of the time, he does not give adequate notice. Example, on Sunday night recently, he emailed me, for your information, I won't be in tomorrow. So I said, Sunday night late. 2 days later, he left a voicemail stating he would not be in for the week due to having to take care of hurricane damage to his home in Fort St. Joe. The delegates must follow this work, thus overloading others. He does not go out into the field to know what is or isn't going on very much. He does not know all of our hardworking, dedicated employees. Some employees recently stated they did not know what he looked like until they saw a picture in the paper. He has not yet developed a CIP, Dirt Road Improvement Plan, as promised, nor have he performed face-to-face annual evaluations with employees since he's been here. He has not brought sports tournaments to our beautiful sports complex. The impact of these tournaments and tax dollars are vital to our community. He authorized the destruction of the historic Hampton Springs pool without board knowledge. He has not resolved Shady Grove Community Center issues, and it's been several months since the project completion when he told the contractor everything was okay. He has not corrected problems from department heads and has not took an interest in citizen complaints from these departments and has not performed thorough investigations and citizen allegations and staff performance. Mr. Lakey went against the board's approved salary for a new job position he created when he changed the rate from $46,000 to $48,686 without board approval. In addition, to my knowledge, Mr. Lakey has not implemented all his job duties that were decided. He has yet to identify the whereabouts of several pieces of equipment that was photographed several months ago by an employee and has not been accounted for. I have asked Mr. Lakey about the status of this investigation and have seen no results as far as this equipment is that was photographed. Mr. Lakey is reported to be moody and not approachable at times. He is said to have unpredictable behavior patterns and not always sure what will set him off. That comes from an employee. One employee has filed a complaint letter against Mr. Lakey for cursing at him. travel from Taylor County on those weekends and has not been present in strong leadership for any of the strong Taylor County that did the hurt. To my knowledge, he is not joining any similar church groups. He is just not visible in our community and seems to not have an interest in getting to know our community and employees. Last week in our board workshop, it was revealed that the county owes $1,300 for late fees and solid waste. The commission is from the show and did not bring it to our attention until we were told to do so. This is the other issue that cost the county. I'm sorry that this relates to job performance. This is all from the testimony. I will let the board speak to anybody who needs to speak. That's all I have to say about that.
Can I be first?
Sure.
I'll be glad.
You can be first.
I concur with many of the things you could do. And, it's kind of like when you get married to a woman or a pretend husband, you got to live with them about a year before you really understand what you're doing. And it's been 21 and a half months since you left me. I helped you to get a very good pay. And you just help them all after yourself. So, I want to be, and I'm going to have to go good terminate your contract. And it's a direct contract, I'm on page 4 of the contract. And I know you're aware of what's in there. Page 4. And I'll leave it to everybody. The employment of employees,
it says,
I'm on page 4.
What paragraph?
It's section 2, paragraph B. The employment of the employees shall be at the will of the board. Nothing in this agreement, this employment contract I'm reading from, shall prevent, limit, or otherwise interfere with the right of the county to terminate the services of the employee at any time, subject only to the provisions set forth in section 3 and 6. Now I'll go to section 3 because it's one of those provisions we're talking about. And there's several pages over here. Hardest thing I've ever done in my life. I do believe. I think a change is necessary, and the question is, I want to hear from the other board members. I'll take the brother, and I'll make the motion if anybody chooses not to do so.
Any other commissioner?
Any other commissioner wants to? I was an employee from Commission Lake, and I tried to separate myself from that, because there were certain morality issues and so forth, and for the first year, you know, I've worked for a lot of different people, and there's always a transition, there's always, a great period. Give people the opportunity to learn the job and learn the area. So I would always, as I've heard other directors speak about, their morale issues, and try to improve that. But when I got appointed, never
what I heard so far, it would be, it would do you an injustice for me to vote for you to stay here now. But those would be impossible, because he was, if he kind of fit. So, whether it's solidified, if you're upset, maybe we need to change and go in another direction. If you give you a break to do something else. I know right now it's 3-1, or 4-1, or 4-5 of them. They can stop and say, we need to change for another direction. I know, you know, that most people don't think you're hard to deal with. What they're right or wrong, I don't know. And I think from what they've been used to, or what we've been used to, somebody get in the field and really, I got to speak to the field time. You don't get this one. A man in the shoes is so sick. And I talked to some of them, don't think you really have the same issue. But they do expect you to go on some social media, go on some church, and be more. You're not a bad person in my book. And so I had to give you a recommendation, I would. But if I set out to get folks to stay right now, what I've heard before, what I've heard, and it would be so I have to do it.
Not here. I'm going to fix this lesson. There's a lot of this lesson that I could say publicly. Some of it might be based on rumor, and some of it would be fact. But I choose not to do that. And my purpose, my heart, is not to destroy a good man. You have a lot of red cloth. I pointed those out to you. There's a place, somewhere, great service. And I, along with them, I don't want to talk about anything that's going to jeopardize your opportunity to go and take care of your family and get success elsewhere. You just haven't been the fit for our community, as I see it. And it's just a chance.
And so, it's my position, because I'm trying to
about this, I've looked for their life. Friends, this is the God. Give him, get God from my kingdom. I read out of the book of Common Prayer, and I read the prayer of the government. And I guess all the books that you read from, you look internally, I suppose, in scripture. Well, remember, for the Bible, you can always look there, Thomas, which is pretty good advice. I helped get you to a good favorite. And I knew early on that this relationship is going to be a little bit rocky. But I owe it to a good man. He has a good quality. To try to help him succeed. And I have fought off this moment with what little influence I have for a long time. But there's sooner or later comes a time. That your emotions go and use your head to make a decision. And you work under a contract. And you don't look off of that contract. God has seen us in a contract out there wherever it was, and he was letting go the other day. And that's the big factor. You know, you just terminate the contract, and this is a very good, favorable contract that's born of. And so, I don't see any benefit in waiting to terminate the contract until January, let's say. It's the same service package you're going to get. 3 months already had benefits, which is about to receive a whole nother one. And you're entitled to that because that's what we agreed to in the beginning. Thing is, we're not a rich country. If we terminate the contract today, for example, then we will have saved $2.5 in it, which is something. If the holiday period comes on, and very little, you don't start big projects, I would think, 2 or 3 days before a holiday period, and you got something coming up. So, for further discussion about here, I have a motion that Mr. Lennon's employment be terminated today in accordance with the provision in his contract that he be paid the full severance package and benefits. Then I vote.
Okay, we have a motion. Is there a second?
No motion.
We have a motion. Is there a second? Thank you.
five figures that's been reviewed in the entire term of your junior year in Devon County, make this decision rather than wait until January 8th. When you got one picture coming on, does that have call and ask for the commission to meet? I think this is time to do it while we're still here, because we know you. And it's not about what, now I don't know where the commissioner is today. I don't know what his feelings are. So, that's your call for the question.
All those favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
I said, thank you, I have a right to hear.
Yes.
Not to put your contract.
Now, I, what we have to do now is, today, today you'll remove your things immediately after, starting, you know, after the meeting. And,
I'd like to see whatever the salary board sets when they select that.
$1,000 to start with, and then you get additional holiday pay and leave time, and then there's just swing day. And I never did think you were entitled to that, but I didn't think about it. But the point is, we need to tighten up the contract a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, we're going to get that this time. But I want to say that we need to tighten up a little bit.
I agree.
Now, you know, I work on board for the general manager. And I was on the board of Scott County when we hired a very competent man, Judy Tackett, to live in his family from Virginia, and that's his clerk. Not ours, county. And he took a big risk, but he wanted to go somewhere in his career. And he didn't ask for a contractor. He said, I work at the little board. If I do my job, I won't need a contractor. And he worked for years over there. He finally insisted upon the size of the legal counsel to give him a contract. And it's specified to think that he won't want it. Don't, you know, he didn't have any salary back then. Didn't want to say that. But 11 o'clock tomorrow, thank you.
Part, I'm just sorry it didn't work out.
Well,
the way that I'm a firm believer. God has planned on I appreciate the opportunity.
Feel my friend. Move in here.